hospital stay is reduced and also the patient, once he goes home, is able to return back to his active work also much faster. The pulmonary functions are preserved better both in the immediate post-operative period and also long-term compared to open surgery. And when you talk about cancer, which is what I am going to be talking about, surgery is not the only answer for most cancers. You have to have combined treatment. It will be combination of surgery followed by chemotherapy or chemo and radiation therapy, or it will be chemotherapy followed by surgery. So there is always mix and match of these all three modalities for treatment of comprehensive treatment of cancers. And when you have a patient with little advanced cancer who has undergone surgery and he requires adjuvant treatment, it should be initiated as soon as possible, preferably within first month. And if your recovery is going to be delayed because of open surgery, then the adjuvant treatment is also going to be delayed and the benefit of adjuvant treatment will be compromised. So if you have VADS or any form of minimal invasive surgery, because the recovery is faster, patient is fit enough to undergo adjuvant treatment much faster in the immediate post-operative period. And of course, for the patient, you know, if I show this slide, whether you want to undergo any surgery in the chest using this kind of an approach or this kind of an approach, the answer is going to be obvious, minimally invasive surgery. So it doesn't require too much of a convincing. Now, as I was telling you, that there is a surgical trauma associated with any surgery. And the bigger the surgery, more is the surgical trauma. And this is reflected in interleukins, you know, which are circulating in the blood in the immediate post-operative period. And this is comparison of IL-4, IL-6 and IL-14 between open surgery and VADS surgery. So you can see the levels are much less when you do VADS surgery. Also, we had done a study in our hospital itself where we compared the pain scores given by patients themselves in the first 5 post-operative days, and you can see patients who had open surgery, pain scores were much higher than patients who had VADS surgery. So it proves that not only the biochemical parameters are much better preserved when you do VADS surgery, but in the clinical setting also, patients also realize that the pain is much less when you do VADS surgery. Now, you know, this is comparison between open surgery and VADS esophagectomy, and you can see here the number of pulmonary complications, significant difference between the two, and this significant difference becomes more and more as you get more experience. The major morbidity parameters are also less in VADS surgery versus open surgery, and the mortality also is reflected here in VADS surgery being less. And because of all these parameters, you find that the interest in VADS surgery has now been growing, from very few publications which were there in 90s, now in 2014 and even more now, 2015, you have more than 600 publications being coming up every year in internationally published journals. So more and more thoracic surgeons and more cancer surgeons are picking, resorting to minimal invasive surgery when doing cancer surgery. But for any new procedure, there are going to be concerns. And what are these concerns? One is cost. This thing is, I think, taken care of because now you have indigenously available minimal invasive surgery instrumentation, monitors and things like that. So what used to be prohibitively expensive, say maybe 15 years ago, is now within reach of most surgeons and therefore most patients. There is of course a learning curve, and nobody should get into doing minimal invasive surgery directly. One has to learn the open surgery, the conventional surgery first, so that he is attuned with the normal anatomy and how to go about. But the most important factors are oncological safety and port site recurrence. Now, no cancer surgery should be compromised just because you want to do minimal invasively so that patient's recovery is fast. Because finally, what you are interested in is long-term cures and not in just immediate post-op results. And as I will show you in the subsequent slides, the oncological safety has been proven by multiple studies, not only in our country but across the world. Port site recurrence used to be a concern, but with better understanding of doing minimal invasive surgery, retrieving the tumors in bag, flushing the port sites with saline and betadine, we now find that port site recurrence is not a problem. Once in a while, when you have these port site recurrences, it is actually a manifestation of systemic recurrence and not only an isolated recurrence. Now, this is to show you how there is no difference in radicality between open surgery and minimal invasive surgery. Now, this is for esophageal cancer. So, number of lymph nodes dissected both in open surgery and in VATS surgery is almost similar. The number of patients undergoing complete surgery, meaning R0 status at the end of surgery, is again similar, in fact more with VATS. And the number of patients who had relapse or died of disease in the post-operative follow-up period is again more or less similar. So VATS or minimal invasive surgery for cancer does not come at cost of compromising the overall survival or the local control rates. And that is most important, because a surgeon who is doing minimal invasive surgery should remember this, that oncological principles cannot be violated when you are treating a patient just for short-term gains. A little bit about the history of video-assisted thoracoscopic surgery. Though, you know, it has become very popular now, actually the first VATS was described by Jacobius way back in 1910. Those days, of course, we didn't have all these fancy instruments, so he used a rigid cystoscope to look inside the chest. And he was using it mainly to create artificial pneumothorax for patients who had tuberculosis, because that was the only treatment available at that time. But since 1990, with development of fiber optic transmission systems, better cameras, 3D, HD, and what you have, and better energy systems, now thoracoscopic surgery has been revisited. And in fact, at present, it's a basic and important technique which all thoracic surgeons should know. Just as all general surgeons or all cancer surgeons dealing with abdominal cancer should know laparoscopic surgery. Now, what all pathologies can be treated using VATS? You can treat both benign as well as malignant pathologies when you're dealing with VATS. Solitary pulmonary nodule, as you all know, is a 3 cm nodule covered on all sides by normal lung, which requires a wedge resection, can be treated with VATS. A patient who has a solitary lung metastasis, a lot of sarcomas, they relapse in lung, and oftentimes they have single or just one or two metastases which are generally peripherally placed. Now the treatment, standard treatment, is to do wedge resection or metastatectomy. And for that, you may not have to do a thoracotomy, you can achieve the same by doing VATS. And of course, if you have lung cancers also, typical T1 and T2 tumors, small tumors, not like, you know, requiring pneumonectomies, but wherever a lobectomy or a wedge resection can be done, you can do a VATS lobectomy even for cancer patients. So you do VATS lobectomy and mediastinal lymph node dissection. When it comes to esophagus, you can tackle almost all the pathologies of esophagus with the VATS technique. So all cancers, whether it is per primum or post-chemo radiation therapy or post-chemotherapy, if it is resectable, can be resected using the technique of VATS. Patients of leiomyoma, not a very uncommon tumor, require only enucleation. And just for that, if you have to open a complete thorax, it's something which can be avoided completely by using VATS technique. And then very rarely you also have duplication cysts, either of the esophagus or of the airway. And that also can be tackled using thoracoscopic technique without actually going through the posterior lateral thoracotomy and the associated morbidity. Coming to certain mediastinal pathologies, thymomas. The treatment for thymoma, if it is resectable, is surgery. And majority of the time you have to do medial sternotomy. But if the tumor is up to 6 cm, it can be easily tackled using thoracoscopy. Patients with myasthenia gravis, where the neurosurgeons or the neurophysicians feel that doing thymectomy is going to help, even in patients with normal thymus, thymectomy can be performed using VATS technique, so you avoid a big incision in the front. And patients who have neurogenic tumors, typically in the posterior mediastinum, if they are moderate or small in size, can be tackled again using minimal VATS technique. And now we have one more step, we have gone one more step ahead. We have this RATS, robotic assisted thoracoscopic surgery. So this is a new kid on the block, and it's very exciting time for any surgeon, whether it is a laparoscopic surgeon or a thoracic surgeon doing VATS surgery. What is robotic assisted surgery? Robotic assisted surgery is nothing but a form of minimal invasive surgery where a surgeon uses the Da Vinci robot. Unfortunately, that is the only system available. They have a monopoly, and that is the system which we use, and use the console and the instrumentation for performing the same surgery. So it's a form of minimal invasive surgery. It's nothing that robot does something differently. But what are the advantages? Why do you prefer to have a robotic surgery over minimal invasive or a VATS surgery? There are certain distinct advantages of doing surgery with VATS. Because you have a camera which is give you magnification, which is 10 times, and there is a 3D imaging. The increased, the instrumentations are such that it can move, the versatility of the movement is much better than the straight instruments of open surgery. Then of course you sit on the console and perform the surgery. So both the surgeon is comfortably operating, and two, whatever tremor movements are there, they are all filtered by the robot. And there are of course, as I said, limitations, just as you have with wax. There is absence of tactile sensation completely. You need to have a very competent assistant, because as a surgeon I am sitting far away from the patient in the console. There is a learning curve, which is true for any surgery. Training is a bit of a challenge, because you will require two consoles. But according to me, all these things can be taken care of with time and experience. But the most important problem or limitation, I would say, is cost. Because today we have only one company manufacturing, the cost of treatment, performing the same surgery could be prohibitive at times. Now I'm going to just end my talk showing you this video, where you will get to know what is the difference between minimally invasive surgery or VAC surgery and robotic surgery, or same surgery. Both patients are undergoing lobectomy. One is undergoing